What's up, guys? So I was gonna do a bit of an intro, but I've got the worst hiccup, so I'm gonna keep it very short. We're on our way to breakfast right now. We're gonna go get. It's because I'm hungry.
Gets rid of it.
I'm hungry. I haven't eaten anything. This morning, JD just did some videography.
It was epic, guys. It was this so morning. Much fun as well. I had
we'll
such
throw
a good
some
time.
Footage in there. So JD's also got another job at lunchtime, so we'll take you guys there as well. So yeah, it's gonna be exciting. Let's go to breakfast so I can stop talking and get rid of these hiccups. So we'll see you guys in the next clip. What do you want for breakfast, babe? It's not open.
They're not open during the week.
Because we're like, oh, it's dead. Like, what's going on? This is sick.
Whoops-o. So to fill you guys in on what we're doing with like our moving situation, yesterday we handed in our resignation. No, that's not it. That's
termination of lease.
Termination of our lease. And we actually don't have a place to go to at this stage.
We are sending out all the vibes to get this place coming right up here. We're gonna show you guys the building. It is epic.
It's that big fat building in the middle there, if that makes sense. It's like a high rise building. It's only a one bedroom, one bathroom, but we're going to go and have a look at this one on Tuesday. Really got our hearts and fingers crossed because like, it just feels really good.
There's aircon, like you guys know at the moment, like not to bitch, but it is, we've got 3 pedestal fans with face washers on just to go to sleep at night.
Yeah, there's been a massive heat wave on the Gold Coast. So it's like, it's not even the heat, it's the humidity at the moment.
But also the energy. The energy at our place, we're big believers in that. And we believe that that place, there's going to be a lot of people on holidays, so the energy vibe there will just be so positive. Like we're really putting that out there that it's a real happy place, and I already feel like we're in it. I can see myself like coming home to Amy.
We've like visualized ourselves. Like we've done so much manifestation for this place. It's crazy. We're gonna go down to Saraba now. We're gonna go to breakfast, and yeah, we'll see you guys. So we just ordered some froth bowls because it's just so hot. Also got some Remedy kombucha. The cherry plum is our favorite flavor. Including in the kitchen, taking over. You right in there? We're just on our way to Temple Gym right now. Little worried, it's gonna be pretty fucking hot. You guys probably wondering why I'm so brown as well. I got a tan yesterday by Bella Bronze. I did like, they needed a model to do like a tutorial on. So I put my hand up and I just got like a free comp tan. They're launching their new vegan comp tan and I'm gonna be using it for my comp day as well. So that's why I'm pretty dark. It's like a comp tan and I only left it on for like literally like half an hour. But I wanted to ask you guys, because I asked the girl and every time I get a spray tan, I get like really, oh, you can't really tell. I have to scrub it off, but it all sticks under my arm. For some reason, the tan always goes really dark under my arms and it like goes all patchy and it's like really disgusting and I don't know what it is. And she says that's probably psoriasis. So I don't notice it when I don't get spray tans, but as soon as I get a spray tan, it just sticks to those areas. So I wanted to ask you guys that if anyone suffers from psoriasis, let me know down in the comments below, like if there's any like natural creams or like remedies or something, because I really want to get this healed before the comp, because last comp day it was so gross. Like literally I put my arms up and it was like 2 black patches underneath my arms. So
and you're like, Amy's not vain or anything, it's just purely that you get marked on your aesthetically, like how you look as well on the day. So
oh, it's just gross. So if any of you guys know of any like natural creams or remedies, please let me know in the comments down below, because I really want to get it sorted before the comp. Thank you.
Sounds good, man. Thanks so much for doing this, mate.
All right.
That's amazing.
It's got to be hardcore shit.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Sick.
Just arrived to Temple Gym. JD's in the background there shooting with Ryan. And look how epic this place is. Hopefully it's not too windy.
Tony Montana.
finished up with the shoot. We're just getting some water. JD's just getting some water at the moment.
10 cent pieces.
10 hours later.
Sweet, this is shit.
A very, very successful shoot. Ryan was like so high energy.
It's honestly like, it does not feel like work for us, hey. It is the best time. Like, I've had the best day today with you, like honestly.
And it just shows like Ryan is prime example, and so is Jack as well. Like, they're prime example of people who are just like dream chasers, and they do what they want. They disregard the opinions of anyone else. The old saying of like, do what you love and you'll never have to work a day in your life again. They're doing what they love every single day and getting paid for it and just enjoying it and just enjoying life and just
getting paid in like money, but also happiness. Like honestly, if you wake up every day and you're stoked on life, it is the best feeling ever.
We chose to like chase our dreams, chase our passions, and it's all gonna pay off.
Universe like plays a part, but you've also got to take initiative.
Yeah.
Like Jim Carrey said it so well on Oprah once. He said, you can manifest things, but you can't then go and sit and eat a sandwich and expect it to come.
Visualization works if you work hard.
Yeah. Well, yeah, that's the thing. You can't just visualize and then, you know, go eat a sandwich.
You've got to like take action, guys. Manifest, but also take action.
Things can't just magically appear if you're just sitting on your ass. That's what we're trying to say. You've got to get up, chase it, but also have positivity, manifest, and it's all like a big combination of all of that.
Yes.
Bundled up in one thing, but yeah. Chase your dreams, guys. That's what we're trying to say. So it's a little bit later in the afternoon. I'm just having some protes at the moment. It doesn't actually look all that great. It's like, we have no almond milk. We've got some oats, protein powder, and just some yogurt on top. Going to the gym in about, like half an hour. JD's been editing like all afternoon. He's absolutely loving it. So cute. So passionate about it. I'm gonna train some back buys, and then I'm gonna do 30 minutes of cardio. Jess is gonna train with Ollie. Not too sure what he's gonna train. So we're gonna throw to JD's edit that he's doing right now. Time it is, guys.
RuPaul's Drag Race.
Friday night means RuPaul's. So it's come to the end of the day. Oh my god, we have had the biggest day.
But a good day.
It was such a good day. And sorry about if this vlog was felt like you guys had just like followed us around and we didn't like teach you anything. But I don't know, we love showing you guys our life and we hope it like inspires you. And if this, if you take anything away from like this particular vlog, it's to show if you have dreams or goals, like just chase them. And
you got to chase it.
Yeah.
Honestly, like at the end of the day, you got to remember that you could die tomorrow. As silly as that sounds, you honestly could die tomorrow. Mm-hmm. So ask yourself, would you be happy right now if you died tomorrow with what you've done in your life?
Yeah. Would you leave this world with regrets?
Yeah.
Or would you ever think like, I wish I did something? Living inside your little bubble in your comfort zone and being afraid of like what people think, or feeling like you're scared of failure. A lot of people are scared of failing things, but to be honest, every time you fail, that's the best thing you could do, because you learn every single time you fail, and every successful person comes from failure. Like,
we've honestly learned so much from our failures.
So many times. Like,
it's ridiculous.
So many times, and I'm glad we have, because that means, okay, that wasn't meant to be, or okay, we had to learn something because of that. So
we've learned so much from our failures.
If you like this video, remember to give it a big thumbs up, guys. It really supports our channel, and leave some comments down below, because we love interacting with you guys.
And we'll see you in the next one.
See you in the next one.
Rice flakes. $3. Tick. Sweets. Do we need sweets? $2.40. This chocolate, guys. Oh, that feels like a dodgy packet. That chocolate. Beep, beep, beep. What up? We can give one tip.